Hello and welcome to an historic reenactment of the 1946 World Series between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Boston Red Sox. Game one on Sunday, October 6, 1946 at Sportsman's Park in St. Louis. The Red Sox got here easily with 104 victories, 50 losses under manager Joe Cronin, finishing 12 games ahead of the second place Tigers and 17 games over the Yankees. For the Cardinals, it was a little tougher. They wound up with a first tie for first place in Major League history with the Brooklyn Dodgers, and they won the best of three playoff series with Brooklyn, 2-0. 4-2 in the opener behind Howie Paulette, and 8-4 in the second game with Murray Dixon and Harry Burkine doing the pitching. The starting lineups for game number one for the Red Sox: Tom McBride in right field, Johnny Pesky at shortstop, Dom DiMaggio in center field, batting cleanup, left fielder Ted Williams. At first base in the number five slot, Rudy York. Then it is second baseman Bobby Doerr, third baseman Pinky Higgins, Hal Wagner will be behind the plate, and Tex Hewson on the mound. Hewson won 20 and lost 11 this year with a 2.75 earned run average. He is a big right-hander, 6'3", 198-pounder. For the Cardinals, starting at second base and leading off, Red Shandinks. Center fielder Terry Moore batting second in the number three spot. First baseman Stan Musial batting cleanup. Enos Slaughter in right field. George Whitey Karowski at third base. The catcher in the opener, Joe Garagiola. The left fielder, Harry Walker. At shortstop, Marty Slats Marion. And on the mound for the Redbirds, left-hander Howie Paulette. 6'1 and a half, 175-pounder. And this year, he was 21 and 10 as he led the league in victories and innings pitched with 266. He had 22 complete games with four shutouts. We'll tell you more about these individuals, of course, as we go along. The umpires for today's opener: behind the plate calling the balls and strikes, National Leaguer Lee Ballenfant. At first base, Cal Hubbard of the American League, Al Barlick of the National League at second base, and Charlie Berry of the American League calling things at third base. So we are ready to get underway. And Tom McBride steps in there against Paulette and swings and misses the very first pitch of this 1946 World Series. Strike one. Johnny Pesky on deck, as we told you. Here is the next pitch, and it's inside for a ball. At Sportsman's Park, by the way, it's 351 feet down the left field line, 422 feet to straightaway center, 354 feet down the right field line. Here's a pitch swung and fouled back. So it is one ball and two strikes on Tom McBride. There's a 33-foot screen from the right field corner out to 354 feet in right center field at Sportsman's Park. Here's the pitch, and there's a swing and a ground ball headed down to third base. Karowski is up with it cleanly, glances at it, fires across to Musial, and one gone as we are well underway now as Johnny Pesky steps in. Pesky is a left-handed batter, and in his rookie season in 1942, he led the league in hits with 205. He hit 331, finishing second to Ted Williams, by the way. This is his first year back after 3 years in the military, and he looks at a pitch low for a ball from Howie Paulette. We have one out and nobody on to get things started here. Here's the next one in there for a call strike, a nice curveball on the outside corner, and the count is even at 1-1. Dom DiMaggio on deck. Paulette gets the sign from Garagiola, delivers. There's a swing and a foul back to the screen, and it is one ball, two strikes. Pesky led the league in hits again this year, his first year back, as we said, with 208, batted 335. Here's the pitch, and it's a fly ball headed out in the left field, high, easy money, though, for Harry Walker, who circles under it and gathers it in, and we have two outs. Brings up Dom DiMaggio. DiMaggio, the little professor out of San Francisco, younger brother of Joe DiMaggio of the Yankees. He's a right-handed batter, little guy, 5'9", 168 pounds. This was his best year yet in 1946 as he batted 316. Takes a strike called. Again, there's that good curveball from Paulette, who is smooth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.